Hi everybody, I'm Ross. We're at the remarkable ski area. Right here we're standing on the bypass, if you like, the trail that's going to feed people back to Shadow Basin. We've enhanced what was initially a wetland that we've modified through this terrain works. These are actually sods that we cut out of a wetland area before we did earthworks on it. And we protected them, we put them into an environment where they were sustained through the winter period last winter, and they've been relocated to this terrain here. I mean, it's green, it's growing, and there's a lot of growth within that as well. Everything's sort of binding together. It's holding a lot of the moisture that it did beforehand. When we talk nationally about wetlands and the importance of them, certainly we recognise that up here as well in this environment. This is epilobium, which is one of the first plants to re-establish in a newly modified area. It started to evolve and grow, and then that'll attract more soil through wind-borne soil movement and that sort of thing, and then other plant seeds will propagate in that as well, and all of a sudden you start to have all sorts of plants growing out of it. I just wanted to bring you to this side. It's an example for me of a great success story. And we actually wanted to widen up Turquoise Trail, which comes down towards us, so that people can fan out more as soon as available into terrain that's there for that. So we uplifted the tussock in big clods with machinery, stored it, and then took the hill down to this big flat terrain up here, and it actually extends up into the base of the slope behind me. And then we reinstated the tussock through here. And as you can see, I mean, to the untrained eye, you wouldn't know any different, but it is something that I consider a success story in that we've been able to do this and achieve it to the standard that we have. If we do earthwork somewhere and depositing excess material and we haven't got enough vegetation to cover the earthworks that we're developing or creating, an example of that is up behind me here. There's a schist face with a digger sitting on top of it. Now, what was there primarily beforehand was a schist face, and we've actually put excess material in there. So the schist face is still there, although it's out another 5 or 6 metres off the original. If you look around at the expanse of the landscape everywhere, there are these schist veins through it. It's not just all vegetation. Where we haven't got enough vegetation, we do use these schist veins to recreate that landscape as looking authentically as it was beforehand. Anywhere where we get this sort of environment, we want to reinstate the landscape and keep progressing these sort of environments. This is something that we're working on, and we progress wherever we do earthworks to grow and develop even more and enhance this sort of landscape.